Anyone can easily make similar solar collectors from these cheap polymer pipes.
Typically, these primitive solar collectors are recommended for heating pool water in the summer, but we will apply them for space heating of a house in winter. Unfortunately, these collectors have a big disadvantage, which will now be demonstrated by one of my experiments. This temperature, 67 degrees Celsius, is the maximum to which solar energy can heat the water inside the black pipes. It was in the summer, but winter temperatures of the water will be much lower, about 30 degrees Celsius above the ambient temperature. Therefore, we understand that several dozen square meters of these solar collectors will heat these several tons of water to a low temperature, less than 35 degrees. We understand that this temperature is not suitable for solar heating of this house. That is why here we add a heat pump that will take thermal energy from the water tank and increase its temperature to the required 40 or 50 degrees. Moreover, our solar collectors are made from several kilometers of this cheap pipe, the surface of which has such a large area of contact with the surrounding air. That is why our long pipes are a good heat exchanger, where the surrounding air transfers its thermal energy to the water inside the pipes. So, let's assume that it is a warm night now, 7 degrees above zero, and it turns out that the water inside several kilometers of the pipes can be heated by the surrounding air to a temperature of about 6 degrees with a power of several kilowatts. But we know that usually the air temperature increases by several degrees the next day. Moreover, a cloudy sky produces a small flow of solar radiation which hits the black walls of the pipes a few degrees above the ambient temperature, and therefore the water inside the pipes can heat up to 10 or 12 degrees Celsius. Nevertheless, we will rarely turn on the solar collectors on cloudy days, and even less often on warm nights, and more than half of the thermal energy will come to the tank during sunny hours, and it will be solar energy. You may think that we have found a new type of heat pump that is cheaper and more powerful than these well-known solar heat pump designs. Our new type competes with this type, where a heat pump takes thermal energy from the ground, and with this type, where the thermal energy is taken from a river or pond. So, it turns out that we installed the same pipes, but not in the soil or water, but in the air. In addition, our pipes must catch solar radiation over an area of several tens of square meters, and almost all of our thermal energy is solar energy, which is accumulated in this water tank. Let's think about how our solar option is better than the traditional heat pump options. First, installing the polymer pipes in the air can be cheaper than this excavation work or this drilling work. In a minute I will tell you an example of heating a house in Ireland, and it has to use 2 kilometers of these cheap pipes, which costs about $1,000. In addition, that example assumes a similar water tank for 7.5 tons of water, 2 or 3 water pumps and several other inexpensive devices and works. This is the second advantage of our type of heat pump, and this is the average temperature of the water in this tank for different months of that Irish example. Moreover, our heat pump uses water that is a few degrees warmer, about here, because it takes water from the top of the tank. At the same time, the temperature of the heat carrier from the pipes at the bottom of a pond in Ireland will be like this, and the temperature of the heat carrier from similar pipes in the ground will be approximately here. We see that our heat pump is using thermal energy with a temperature 10 or 20 degrees higher, and therefore it consumes almost 1.5 times less electricity than the traditional heat pumps. Perhaps one of my future videos will describe the space heating project for the Irish house in more detail, but now I will describe only the most important features of that space heating. We see that winter in Ireland is warm, and this is the average air temperature during the heating season near Dublin. These are the heating needs of a house near Dublin with an area of 100 square meters. Unfortunately, the winter months in Ireland have a small amount of sunny days, and this is thermal energy due to the absorption of solar radiation by our 2 kilometers of pipes during sunny hours. We see that this solar energy completely covers these heating needs in March and April, but these months provide little solar energy. Therefore, the house has this heating deficit, approximately 29% of this annual heating needs. The deficit is covered by the work of our pipes in cloudy days and warm nights, and by some backup heating. The percentage of the backup heating in the total heating of the house is not large, several times less than those 29%, and we have the following two possibilities to eliminate the need for backup heating. First, we can increase the area of solar collectors and the length of their pipes, and increase the volume of water in the tank. Secondly, we can buy approximately such pipes for antifreeze, which will move thermal energy to the heat pump. 200 meters of this thin pipe in the tank allow about 1 ton of ice to freeze on the outer surface of the pipe. The freezing of that 1 ton gives the heat pump almost 100 kWh of thermal energy, which is enough to heat the house for 3 frosty cloudy days. That ice will melt quickly due to the heating of the tank water by our cell collectors during sunny hours or non-frosty cloudy days. Nevertheless, that Irish project did not use these pipes, but the following solution. This low-power pump takes water from the top of the tank and moves it to the heat pump, where the water gives up its heat and returns to the bottom of the tank. I also wanted to add this second pump, which is turned on by a thermostat when the water temperature drops below 5 degrees Celsius, and adding it to the work radically increases the water flow through the heat pump. I thought the second pump would reduce the icing problem here. The type of solar collectors of the Irish project is intermediate between these two cases, closer to the left case, with small gaps between adjacent pipes. 2 kilometers of those pipes form solar collectors on a total area of 50 square meters with these energy parameters. These are bad parameters, and they are almost 2 times worse than these expensive solar collectors for swimming pools, and about 20% worse than such cases when the pipes are laid on a black surface. All solar collectors use one similar pump with such properties, and it will operate about 700 hours per year, during sunny hours, sometimes in cloudy weather, and very rarely on warm nights. The pump takes water from the bottom of the tank, and then its flow is divided into 10 or 20 parallel flows, each of which goes through 1 or 200 meters of the solar collector pipe. Thus, the solar collectors used water, not antifreeze. Downtimes due to water freezing in those 2 kilometers of pipes has already been taken into account here, where I wrote how much heat is produced by the solar collectors during sunny hours. These second numbers are related to this average temperature of those 7.5 cubic meters of water in the tank. We see that the average water temperature decreases in December and November, and therefore the tank gives this additional thermal energy to the heat pump. But here the tank takes useful energy, because its average temperature increases from February to April. These numbers are the electrical component of the heat pump, which converts this amount of solar heat with this efficiency. I want to clarify that the Irish project is not my recommendation, because it has a lot of room for improvement. It was just an attempt to see what results these primitive solar collectors could produce. For example, I doubt the long lifespan of these polyethylene pipes, even if they are protected with black paint, especially if the water often freezes in the pipes.